Hello friends, this is Vikram from Data Edge Learning, and today we are going to see one of the important services provided by the Google Cloud. So for more videos on the Google Cloud, stay tuned, please subscribe my channel. Let's start what actually the data proc is. So if you simply search into the Google, what actually the Google Cloud service which is providing the Azure data proc, you will be find this link over here. It's nothing but it's saying data proc is a managed Spark and Hadoop services that lets you to take advantage to open source data tools for batch processing, querying, streaming, and machine learning steps. So what we understood from this one? So it's simply saying, if you want to work with the Hadoop and Spark services provided by the Google Cloud, you don't need to install any of the services separately, like the Spark installation, like the Hadoop installation, and others. So by default, the Google will provide you the service through which you can be able to make use of the Spark and Hadoop over here. So we'll see the very first link itself, and we'll see what actually the data proc, what are the service benefits of using this one, and then I'll be showing you the practical demo for this one. So if you see this link over here, what actually the data proc, so it is saying the same thing. Then why use data proc? The reason for using the data proc is that it is providing you the very low cost service, super fast service, integrated, managed, and other things. So everything I am leaving to you, how you can be able to get all these things, because I don't want to waste the timing by simply reading all these documents and other things. Anyhow, I'll be saying, sharing this data proc link into the description of the video from where you can be able to get it out. Now let's quickly jump to the Google Cloud. I am already logged into my free trial account for the Google. Now how we can be able to find it out the data proc into this one. So first of all, we need to navigate to this Google Cloud platform. And from this, we need to come down over here and search for the big data section. Once you come to big data sections, you will be able to find it out the data proc option over here. Let me show you, see here, big data, and it is having the data proc. So what you can do, you can simply click on this data proc. And for running and executing of this data proc, it may need a couple of the times that you can start working on this one. Now it is saying data proc is not enabled. So because we are trying to use data proc into this cluster first time, so you have to click over here, it will automatically redirect to this one. Once you enable this one, we will again go back to the data proc, set up the cluster, and I'll be showing you how we can be able to set up the. I'll be showing you how to set up the data proc cluster. So just wait for a few seconds, let it be completed. Yeah, hi. So right now we can say, it is saying data proc API not enabled on this project, redirecting. I think we have already enabled the projects. So we'll replace it first. And now what we need to do, we need to create the cluster for the data proc. So for that we can create this button. Click on this create cluster button. Once you click over here, it will redirect over here with the some requirement that you need to fill it out. So very first thing, the cluster name. You can give anything. Right now I'm giving my data proc. You can give any name, whatever it is suitable for you. Then region and location, you can change it, but I am leaving at the default one itself. And here it is suggesting me the standard one master end node. So I'll be leaving this as also the default. Now, auto scaling policy, none, everything you can leave it like the blank itself. And you can see this option, the image type and versions. If you want to change this one, because it is showing with respect to the Debian pane, I'll be clicking on this one. and you will be find a lot of the links over here. So from this link, we can select any of the things, any of the available options. So which options we can select it, that I am going to show you. We were here for a few minutes. So I will be making use of the Ubuntu, and this one Ubuntu 18 with Hadoop 2.9 as far as 2.4, or we have the Hadoop 3.0 as far as 0. Yes, so I'll be selecting this one and click this button. Once you have selected this Debian and other things, what you need to do, you need to just come down and scroll over here, and that's all. So everything you have done. Now what you need to click, so you need to click on the get. It will take, okay, so having some issue with the data proc cluster name, so I, because of the camel case, I need to change it out, and I am giving into the small case now my data proc and click on this create. It will take again CPU quota. Yes, let me change that one. Down one component. No, we don't want to create any configuration. These all are the optional, so we will not focus much on this one. Instead of 500, you can decrease it to 300. The standard persistent space, ending purpose N1, CPU version 4, leave like all these things. Try to create now. Multiple validation insufficiency quota details on this quota. Okay, so we need to send the CPU quota now. So we need to scroll down over here. Number of the work. Okay. For CPU 15. Okay, we can choose this one. 2B CPU and 7.5 GB of the memory. Let's see this option. And yes, here it will take a few minutes to. It will take a few minutes to cluster to get created. So I'm pausing my video. Please wait. Yeah, so thanks for your valuable time. And now we can see that my data pro cluster has been created, and you can see it's showing the currently the running state. Now what, how to access this one, and what are the things that we need to get from this one. So let me show you this one. If you click over here, the data prop itself, now currently nothing is, we can be able to see, simply you can see that it is getting created. So just come over here, click on this one. It will be a little bit slow kind of the thing. So please bear with the time and please wait. How we can be able to see all the things from this one. So if what the cluster is getting created, we can see the all the details from this one. And like the how many jobs is running and what are the things we are doing. So currently we are not any running any job. We are not having any VM instances as of now, configuration details and other things, so that we can check it out. Yes. Now, if you see in the VM instances, I have created one master with the two worker nodes, and you can see these are the two worker nodes over here, worker 0 and worker 1. Okay, so how you can be able to access this one? So the masters can be accessed through the SSH, and you can click over here. Okay, you will find these many options over here. So how to connect with this one? So you can simply open the browser window. Okay, we can make use of this one. Open in the browser window. Click on that. It will open the page like this one, pop-up page, which will show you your cluster name with hyphen m. That is nothing with but it's the master node. Let it be connected. We can make it full screen now, and it is saying transferring SSH key to the virtual machine. So first time it is getting created, so there will be transfer rate. It will be a little bit slow. Again, it will depends upon the network traffic and the zones where we have created it. So anyhow, it's for the purpose of the learning another thing. So forget about that as of now. We can see into the upcoming videos how we can make use, we can reduce the traffic and other things into my another channels, which we are having the more videos for that. Now you can see it is having the detailed login over here, and this was the my email ID by which I have created my account. So that will be by default your username, and that your cluster name is the my data proc-m. Now what you can do, you need to verify what are the services, whether what the services like Hadoop and other Spark you have available into this data proc cluster or not. So how to verify that one? What are the possible way to verify, right? So if we want to verify like Hive is working or not, if we want to verify what are the available processes which is running into my machine as of now, so this is the JPS command. If you hit it, it's saying nothing is executing as of now, right? Now I'm going to check the Hive, whether Hive is installed or it is activated or not. So you can click over here. If Hive is working, it means all other things is also working properly. Now something is getting started, and now we can see that we have the Hive shell over here. Let me create one command at the Hive, like show databases, execute it. Yeah, so it's working fine. It means there is no issue with this one. It is showing that currently we have only the default database available into the Hive and other things. So it means Hive and Spark all are working properly. So just exit from this Hive cell. Okay, we will make use of the Spark cell to see whether Spark is installed or not. So to check that, we have the spark-cell command, and now we can see it is showing that something related to Spark is getting triggered, and now it is about to start the service of the Spark, and now it is saying Spark sessions available. Now you can see Spark persons, what we have used, the same is available and it is getting created. Means everything is fine. Okay, so for Spark, let's see the context. If you want to go in depth about the Spark and Scala things, you can follow my another tutorials. Let me show you one of the things like SC, the SC dot Python, and these many features are available, APIs are available. It means everything is successfully installed and data proc is working properly. So I'm stopping my videos for this session over here. We'll connect to another video for more informative and practical knowledge of the Spark with Scala and other Google Cloud related videos. Thank you. Stay tuned for my next videos.